Once your modified T-cells arrive back at MD Anderson Cancer Center and your care team clears you for treatment, you'll receive lymphodepleting chemotherapy, usually cyclophosphamide and fludarabine, but may include others. These chemotherapies make room for the CAR T-cells to grow and multiply. You'll usually receive 3 days of lymphodepleting chemotherapy, followed by 2 days of rest. You'll then receive the CAR T-cells the next day. Many patients can receive lymphodepleting chemotherapy as an outpatient in the ambulatory treatment center. However, some may need to be admitted to the hospital. The CAR T-cells may also be given as an inpatient or outpatient, depending on your medical condition and the cell product you will receive. If you receive the cells in the hospital, you may need to stay for several days after the cell infusion so the care team can watch you for side effects. If you receive the cells as an outpatient, you'll go to the ambulatory treatment center for the infusion, followed by daily visits there for 10 days after the cell infusion, so the care team can monitor you for side effects. It may be helpful to think of the CAR T schedule as a countdown that begins with day minus 5 as the day you start lymphodepleting chemotherapy to day 0 when you receive the cells. On days minus 5, minus 4, and minus 3, you'll have lymphodepleting chemotherapy and then rest on day minus 2. The care team will let you know if you will need a pentamidine infusion on this day to prevent a certain type of pneumonia. On day minus 1, you will not have therapy. If the plan is for you to receive CAR T cells in the hospital, you'll be admitted that afternoon or evening. If the plan is for you to receive the cells as an outpatient, then this will be a day of rest for you. Day 0 is the day of your CAR T cell infusion. Talk with your care team if you have any questions.